So, back in. It's Friday afternoon. We're cracking on with the van. Now, when I left you, I just finished a lot of the sanding, and I've done a little bit. I did do a short video yesterday because I spent about an hour off it after work. Finished the sanding and put the first layer of primer on. And since then, the primer was a high build, a white high build primer, and the ratio was 4:1. And I've just put the last of it on. I've kept a little bit left because, well, I'll get you in, I'll show you. But before we do that, pause the video, go and get the kettle on first, get yourself a nice cup of tea, and I'll do the same, and I'll catch you over by the van. See you in a bit. I won't be long, 2 minutes. 2 minutes, stop. Oh, it's hot. Ooh. So the plan, where we are now. A lot of the sanding has been done, big structural stuff. I'm not perfect, and it doesn't look perfect. And for a start, I don't want it to look perfect. If you go back to my previous video and have a look, there's a short clip at the start of that where I first purchased this and went to pick it up. And it was great, rough, patinaed. Yeah, patina that had gone much too far into rust and holes. But yeah, I loved the look of it. Stickers all over it. It looked like it'd seen some action. Do you know what I mean? And I wanted to keep that sort of ambiance, if you will, if you want to get continental about it. So I don't want it to be perfect, but I did want to sort out the rust. Big thing. I want this to still be around. And ultimately, for a 40-year-old vehicle, the rust was really good. The rust really wasn't that bad. I know I was going on saying that there was loads wrong with it, and the more I was digging into it, I was finding more. I was, but it was little stuff. So most of that's been sorted now. Yeah, it's rough, whatever. And then primer's gone on, first coat, just dust it, nice and light. And then second coat, as much as you like, because it's high build primer. And the idea behind that is you put loads on, and then you get to sand that off again. So you sand it again. So any imperfections or little stuff that I might have missed with the filler should be more or less filled up with the primer. And then I can sand it off again. Yeah. So the idea is that ultimately when you come to put the final coat of paint on, or few coats of paint on, looks good, bro, looks good. So, what that's left to do now is, I haven't done the roof, I haven't touched the roof, I haven't primed that at all, because the paint that I've got is, it's like an armour paint. In fact, come on, I'll come and show you the paint, come and have a look what I've got anyway, come on.
So this is the paint that I've got for the roof. Just an armour skin. It's thick. They do like truck beds in them, and it's very thick anti-everything paint. So that was, I think, 17 quid a bottle. The primer is over here. Ooh. 4:1 primer. I wanted high build, but I don't think he's given me high build, so I just bought two tins of that, put loads of that on. I've still got a little bit left in there because when I start sanding, yeah, see, I've gone a bit too hard. But when I start sanding stuff down, sanding this down, obviously if I have any low spots, I'm going to want to paint on, and then, so I've got a little bit saved. And the black, which I did have somewhere, which has now disappeared. It was in a, oh, it's here. I've just got some matte black spray paint, which I'm going to do for round here. All this, from this runner up, is going to be matte black up to the gutters on both sides, and then that's going to be armour paint the roof. This will be matte black, and then from here down, yellow, which is this one here. Yellow. Oops, that one. And that is 2-1, I think, 2-pack. You can't get lead-based stuff anymore, which is a shame, because I used to like the smell of that when I was doing it with Dad when I was a kid. Yeah, controversial subject, but it's just the way it was. So my plan for today is this, as follows. So the primer's done. Happy with the primer. It will need sanding. There's a couple of flies in it, bits and bobs. I'm not gonna touch sanding here now. I've done days of sanding and I don't want to do any more right now. Just the minute, just wanna have a little bit of a break. So what I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna mask from here down off. And then I might have a go at painting the ceiling. Painting the roof. There is a water leak which I need to address. However, it's not raining today, which is good news. So I'm gonna dry that leak up. I might look at moving the van back about a foot and a half, just so that it's not, I don't want the paint to be drying and for it to rain tonight and then get, yeah. So that's the plan. Start masking all this off. In fact, I'll show you the paint. Show you the paintwork. Yeah, it runs all over the place. It's a lot thinner. I don't think it is the high build primer stuff, because the high build primer goes on thick as hell and sticks like a sticky thing. And this went on very thin and was running and all sorts. You know, you can see I've managed to sort of semi-save that one. Now, with runs like these, it doesn't matter in primer. I'm just going to get a... but it, even in main paint, like the main paint you put on, the finishing coat, if you just get wait for it to go dry and hard, get a really fine, fine sandpaper and just take the ridge off until it's flat and then polish it and then it'll come up fine. But because this is going matte, I'll just sand it and then matte it, doesn't matter. But you can see, now the reason why I had to use white primer was because this bottom half is going yellow. And if I'd used grey primer, that would have shown up. You can see I did have a bit of grey primer on here, but covered it all now. This side as well, because that's getting armour painted up. So it's not bad. Oh, looks like there's a leak here as well. Great. And that's got under the paint. Top dog. You can see where I've been with the filler. This is all filler. This here, this bit, this is all filler. That wasn't done by me. I saw a bit of rust and decided to chase it with the grinder, and then it was just all filler, so I've decided to leave it alone. And then the boot, which was not an original boot, it's off a different van. But it's come up fine. Custom jobby tailgate. And it looks like when they were putting it on, they've bent this under, split all the paint and all that. Well, in fact, it hasn't really rusted, but it's just, the paint's just, I mean, look at it. Top notch. Obviously, so that's gonna get a load of paint. I might spray all that black, get some thick paint on that. Run, nice, and we come full circle. So right, I'm gonna jump onto masking and then try and paint the roof without killing myself or breaking my neck. Thank you.
So, yes, for those of you watching still, this is what 90% of painting a car or a van looks like. It's the five P's, all right? The five P's. Preparation prevents piss poor performance. This is all preparation. The more preparation you spend or do, the better your paint's gonna be. And it is just hours of this. But the more care you take and the more time you take making sure it looks good and that everything's covered, it'll save you ball ache and heartache later on, right? The less time you spend in preparation, the more time you spent in correction, all right? Because if something goes wrong and you get paint on something you're not supposed to get paint on, unless it's glass, you're in the shit. So you want to try and be as careful as you can, as concise as you can. Get in there, please. Good. Okay. Right. I'm going to crack on with the rest of this, the back, and then to the side. You can see that I'm not going all the way down. I'm just going from underneath the skirt and then making my own newspaper skirt, just to, as I'm spraying the top, I don't want any back spray getting onto ledges or window sills and stuff where I don't want black paint, basically. So I'm going to do this, I'm going to do the other side, and then I'll come back to you when I'm ready. The newspapers are wank, aren't they? Waste of time. Right, it's most of the masking done now. I've just dried up that water and then sanded the paint where it had bubbled under. So I'm not too fussed about the finish on the roof, but you can see this bit. So I'm sort of bothered about the finishes that you can see, but on top of the roof, couldn't give a shit. Who's going to be on the roof apart from me? So yeah, that's where I'm at. Looking at it, I'm going to get some of that panel wipe. I'm going to wipe all the residue and all the stuff off, and just give it that, and wait for it to dry. Just give it that best chance of paint sticking, and then we'll get onto it. Oh, missed a bit. Have I? Yes. You will see that I haven't gone full hog with the masking, as you can see. Yeah, I haven't done all of this because I'm painting the roof. I just want to catch the overspray, really. So when I'm painting and it goes over, I want an immediate capture. If it gets freckled down on the bottom or the sides, I'm not too fussed about that because I can just sand it off. It's only primer. There's paint going on over this, so I can sand it off. So panel wipe next in the roof, and then I'll have a look for a Schultz gun. So the whole point of the panel wipe is it's like a degreaser. It's like it's not paint thinner or anything like that, but it's a chemical that, how can I say, it evaporates as well. So it's like a chemical that gets rid of any imperfections. It's to wipe it off without ruining the paint, so that when it dries and you paint onto it, it's not gonna leave anything that's gonna react with the paint. So you might see with certain like acrylic or vinyl paints, and if you try to paint on top of them, anything, not automotive, but any sort of different paint, and if you try and paint on top of it, like a gloss, and then try to paint a matte on top of it, it'll start to fisheye and it'll go all weird and start to clump and react with each other. Well, this prevents that. Because there's been a mixture of different paints in this, and if you remember on the boot lid, that was all crazy paved because that was a latex based paint that had been applied wrong or however. With that, me sanding that off and then dust particles through the air, and then there'll be dust on there, and if I just try to wipe it off and then paint onto it, there may be residue left and that might react with the, yeah, it's cheap as chips. Just buy it and just get a rag and just clean, just do the clean again. The five P's. Remember the five P's. Have you heard the Beatles' new song? That Now and Then. It's lovely, isn't it? It's pretty cool what they've done. Who thought Yono Ono would pull through for the Beatles? How the fuck she? She must have had like an epiphany, or they're paying her like a bazillion quid. Sorry for all the noise. This is a working yard. Again, I can't be any more thankful to the owners to let me use this. I usually do a lot of stuff in my own little unit, but I've got about enough room to fit this in, and then that's it. I can't get around it, I can't get on top of it. I need the space to do something like this, and I'm very lucky to know people that are able to let me use this. So again, I know I mentioned it in the last video, I can't be any more grateful. I know I'm here a lot more than I should be. So yes, thank you very much. Right, do the other side. I'll get back to you when I'm ready. Okay, it's came the time. I'm going to paint this. I'm going to try and do a bit of a thin coat of it. There's no hardener or anything with it. Or there might be, actually. Yeah, there is. And it goes on. I've just been trying to work it out how I'm going to do it. Because I was thinking I could get on the roof and pay from and go like that and walk back with it. And then do the last bit on the ladder there. Or I could just do side to side. Into out, into out, into out, into out this side, and then swap over to the other side using my right hand. I feel like doing that, or maybe going from out to in and then sort of dust off, out to in, dust off, out to in, dust off. Do you know what I mean? Like that? I don't know. Jury's still out. We'll work it out. I'll probably just. It doesn't have to look nice, so I'm just going to do it from side to side. Sod it. Anyway, I'm rambling. This is the paint. I've showed you the paint, but all you need is a Schultz gun. Got the hardener for it there, I think. Ugh. Yeah, that's the one. All right, bring that over here. Nice clean work surface, guys. Yeah, look, loads of room. And I got Schultz gun, left it soaking here. Bit of an old one, but still works. We'll get it going. Right, give it a go. Right. I hope there's room in here to put the hardener in. You'd think they would do. You'd think they'd leave room. I hope it's not Brimmers and I have to like drink a bit to get the Schultz gun in. That's all dry now. I'll just give it another quick look over just to make sure that there's no flies on it. Which there was, but there's no bits that need sanding at all, apart from that bit. And fuck it, let's get some paint on it, eh? I'm sick of this. I've not used this stuff before. Right, well, it's fucking black. Is there room? It's black, I can't see. Come on, Lord. Tell you what, an easier way. Where's the bloody paint? Okay. So the paint's... So there's about half of... So that's how deep I went in. So about half of that's paint, which is a bit weird. Thought there would be more in it than that. Rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Right, what was this again? I don't know what ratio it is. Very good. Mix it professionally. I'm pretty sure that's... Well, they're made, aren't they, to be used? So I would have assumed... I'm probably wrong. The comment section's probably going absolutely mental, but... It's fine. It's the roof. Oh, it's a bit goopy. Goop, goop, goop. Goop. Oh, I need to get the compressor on. Shine. Right, I'm going to get the compressor on. I'll get time lapse on the go. And hopefully, then you won't hear me swearing when I make a mistake or ruin this. Right, same as with anything. Nozzle's clear. Yup. I'm going to test it before we get up there and start spraying stuff. Going on, I mean, I don't know. I'm not keen on the Schultz gun. I think I need a new Schultz gun. I think the one I'm using is like the first one ever made. It's not great, but it is mottled. It is going to be a bumpy finish because obviously I'm putting it on with a Schultz gun. It's designed to be like an armored paint, but of course it's quite uneven. But it will level out. It levels itself out because it's like goes on gloopy and then all settles. That's one can down. I've got one more can, so I might have to get another one. Maybe. I'm literally halfway done. Maybe a little bit more that side, but that's it at the minute. It's looking quite good. I like the texture. I like the finish. But I started here and it started coming out and I was like, oh my God, is this the right stuff? But yeah, I just think the Schultz gun has had its day a little bit, but it's doing the job. I've had to take the nozzle completely out for it to do anything at all. Because at first it was coming out, it was just like a cone, like that big, like a 10 pence piece, and it was taking, would have took me all bloody week to do the roof. So I'm gonna crack on with this, get the second can on the go, and then see how much I've got left to do at the end. All in all, not terrible. We'll see how it dries. I might have to get one more tin. But yeah, not terrible. Not bad at all. I did run out before I could do... I wanted to do under here as well. But, oh, it's no biggie. There's a couple of bits where I've sort of missed. It's difficult to see with the light, with it being dark. Because all I've got is that. And that goes off when the compressor comes on. So this side's in complete darkness. But I'm happy with the finish of it. I'll let it settle and let it dry out. And I'll probably come and have a look at this on Sunday, maybe Monday next week. I'll give it a couple of days. So that's about all I've got time for now. It's getting pretty late, and I need to get home once I get all this off. But yeah, I'm happy with that. I wasn't expecting it to be so coarse, so violent, but I suppose that's the Schultz gun, isn't it? But that's what you're supposed to use. Well, it comes in the bottle. You've seen the bottle. So, yeah, I'll wait for it to settle, see how it stipples and that. I'll come back to it in a couple of days, probably Monday. It's Friday now, so I'll probably leave it a couple of days to settle and dry. And then I'll get another bottle, I think. Do underneath these runners, these gutters, and then just any bits that I've missed, really. Try and get it even, because it was difficult with the Schultz gun. I think that Schultz gun's like the first one that was ever made. Bloody crap it is. So, if you like what you like, please give it a like. And if you want to have a look at some of my earlier videos as well, there's a video previously that I did to this when I was taking all the bits off and sanding. You can go and have a look down there. That should be in up there, I think, or I'm not sure. If you want to have a look through some of my earlier videos as well, where I've got a previous video where I'm sanding this, or have a look further back, I've got loads of stuff. V8, Jensen Healy's, Reliant Scimitars, V6s, I've got loads of stuff on there. So trove through there and go and have a look. And next time you see me, we'll be doing more of this. More painting, yes. So without further ado, thank you very much for watching. And I'll catch you next time when I'm doing more on that. See you in a bit.